Hi, this is Toby with HMC Electronics. We're going to be taking a look at the Scienscope HD video inspection system.
So we've got two boards here, one obviously older tech, and then one far smaller modern tech. We're going to review both of these under the system. Let's go over the basic setup of this system, and then we'll go over the tech specs. So the unit features a macro lens, which has a 7-inch to infinity working distance, very different to a regular stereo, binocular, or trinocular microscope system. A macro lens can work as far away from a product as you wish, but you're losing magnification. For our purposes, for the purposes of electronics, working at a 7-inch distance, you can have a 40 power magnification on this monitor here. As you back up and back away from the product, that 40 power goes down. The nice fact that goes with this system is that there is such a thing as a 2x coupler. That coupler goes between the camera and the macro lens, and that increases your magnification up to a range of 80 power. So you've definitely got a lot of options on this system just with regards to magnification that you wouldn't see on a trinocular system. So you've got loads of working distance between the product, and you've still got a really high magnification. The system is available with a number of lighting options to suit both your budget and preference. When it comes to trinocular systems where you've got a camera involved, we see a lot of people going with fiber optic, and we also see a number of people staying with LED. And let's quickly go over these for this system, this video system. LED, a very bright white light. LED light sources are generally dimmable, which gives you a lot of flexibility. Too much light, you've got a little glare, you can dial it back down. They're very energy efficient. LED bulbs last for years. Fiber optic, which is powered by a halogen bulb, those light sources still, for the most part, are giving out more light than an LED. They're not particularly efficient. They can be costly to run because it's a high wattage bulb you're putting in there. But if you need a lot of a light flooding the area, we still see a lot of people going with those halogen bulbs and the fiber optic light guides. So those are still popular. When you look at fluorescent, it's the lowest cost option. We see them very often being used on binocular microscopes. It'll shave a few hundred dollars off a price point. I don't think for a $2,500 or $2,800 system, saving a couple hundred dollars on a light source is really worth it. So I would probably say LED or fiber optic is the best choice to go for this system. Just as with lighting options, all of the microscope packages come with a number of different stand options. This system here is shown with the dual arm boom stand with the gliding ball bearings, making for a nice fluid motion. The other options include an actual gliding arm, as they call it. It's an anodized material. It's designed for use in a clean room application because it's not a coated or painted material. And it also has a surgical grade stainless steel, whereas this is just a stainless steel. The lowest cost option is the single arm boom stand. Single arm boom stand, obviously just having one post here and then your vertical post. One thing to note on any boom stand is this extra collar that is around your vertical post. This is a safety collar. As you need to move your height, set this down, and this is going to prevent your unit from coming crashing down. If accidentally you loosen this, it just falls onto that collar there. We've already reviewed the properties of the macro lens, its capability for magnification up to 40 power. Let's now review the camera that is supplied with this. This is an HDMI output camera going into this 10-inch widescreen format monitor. Monitor is housed in aluminium casing, so very robust, nothing plastic here. The camera sends an image out at a rate of 60 frames per second. If you look at other units, especially when you look at USB cameras, you look at a frame rate that is dependent on the size of the image, scaling of the image, at full screen resolution, which is the only way that this thing projects, it's 60 frames per second. So no choppy image, a very clear image without any sort of delay of any sort. The camera has a half-inch color sensor, giving it great image quality and also color definition, which is very important. Color and contrast, very important when you're looking at a circuit board. The nice thing about this camera is that in the back of it, it has a slot for an SD to USB memory card, which is provided, so you can do documentation. So let's say you're looking at a circuit board and you find a fault, you can take a HD quality snapshot of that and then share it with the rest of your team just by simply removing that card, sticking it in a USB port on your computer directly, downloading those images, sharing, adding text, whatever you might need to do. The camera has a number of features which are accessible via the remote control that's provided. One of the things that it has is its auto white balance. This takes a moment. It is very important, though, that you do this at least once, perhaps even on a weekly basis. Now, what this does is you'll see the screen is changing color. It is trying to figure out what is white, and all I have done is put a piece of white paper under there, and the screen is scrolling through, and now it's set. As you see, it just takes a moment, but very important that you do that, and you can actually then tinker around with your brightness, your color and contrast. They also have a contrast feature, which I'll show you once we get a board under here, and some video calipers. So let's show those off right now. So this is the board that we are going to inspect under the system. Let's get that positioned there. Right before I did this, I couldn't get the lens in focus, and this is quite common. I think a lot of people are used to having a very short working distance. I had set it up and it was probably only about 5 inches away. If you find you cannot get your screen in focus, chances are your lens is just too close to the product. So it's important that it's 7 inches. You can get away with 6.5, but to be safe, 7 inches away from the product to whatever you wish. Right now it's probably closer to 8 or 9 inches away. Taking a look at the features on the monitor again. High dynamic range. We're going to start with this. Application specific, process specific. As you can see as we scroll through them, getting a rather extreme contrast, but I think you'll agree, going from having it set completely off to the second setting, you can actually get a better look at the board on this second setting. I can also then digitally enhance the clarity, currently set to 0, 1, 2, and 3. Again, I would probably say in this board, for this application, which obviously we're just doing an inspection, perhaps Clarity 1 with that digital enhancements looks rather good. Taking a look at the crosshairs here, again, scrolling through the remote, black or white crosshairs, turn those off, and going to our video calipers. Now you have an option for horizontal and vertical lines. When you get your lines set on, you can then scroll through to get different colors. There you go, you can see my colors there, and then you can move these horizontally or vertically, positioning them where you may need to, so that you can in essence set up like I said, a video caliper, set and see that your product is correct dimensions within a box that you've preset, whatever might suit for your application. And again, you've got your color options here, scrolling through, white right there, and then moving it around as needed.
Here at HMC Electronics, we understand that a microscope is a significant purchase. And with that being said, we do not expect you to purchase this system without getting the opportunity to try before you buy. HMC Electronics is proud to be a nationally franchised distributor for the Scienscope line. That means we have access to their network of reps in every territory across the United States. If you are interested in seeing this or any Scienscope system, reach out to us via phone or email. We can arrange an on-site demo of the system, guide you through the process of getting one of these wonderful units into your facility as soon as possible.